We've all been there. You desperately have to use the bathroom, and just as you go in for the kill, you realize it's already occupied. Praying that the person inside this stall is rocking a number one, your hope for a clean toilet erodes away with every passing second. Then the door swings open, and you're instantly aware it was a number two. Now that you've been confronted with gastrointestinal chemical warfare, you do what any normal person would do. You pull your shirt over your face and protect your delicate nostrils from the toxic, biological, gaseous filth that was left behind. But is this method really doing anything? Is the shirt over the face maneuver fact or fiction? When we are faced with the smell from hell, we pull our shirt up and over our nose, thus creating a barrier between our lungs and the outside air. This, in fact, is very similar to how a respirator works. A respirator has two features that protects you from the harmful open air that smells disgusting. The first is a particle filter that physically blocks things like bacteria, dust, and mold from entering our new, clean, breathable air. The second feature removes toxic chemicals such as paint fumes, noxious vapors, and even a nerve gas like sarin. This happens through a process called absorption that traps toxic particles on a liquid or solid surface, much like how cigarette filters trap tar before it enters the lungs. To properly achieve this second form of filtration, most respirators use the absorbent material activated charcoal, which is actually the same activated charcoal that has been all the rage for whitening your teeth, but also makes your smile look like a leftover campfire. In order to better understand our shirt method, we need to figure out exactly what is in the air post-poop that smells so disgusting. When poop is flushed down the toilet, a plume of bacterial aerosol and fecal matter is thrown up into the air. And it's this airborne fecal matter bacteria mix that is smelling up the joint, along with hydrogen sulfide gas, the same gas that makes farts smell so disgusting. This stinky bacteria stuck inside water droplets are actually much larger than the bacteria itself at 1 micron in size. And professional grade respirators can actually block objects as small as 0.3 microns in size. And if we think of our shirts like poorly designed respirators, we're in luck. Because not only are our shirts made of the same material as professional grade respirators, but they also have woven properties that can at least block some of the water droplets containing these stinky bacteria. Also, if your shirt were damp from, let's say, sweat or just normal body moisture, the water stuck in the cotton fibers could dissolve and trap some of the hydrogen sulfide gas. And while respirator filters are much more efficient as they are less porous than our shirts and contain absorbent materials designed for air purification, your shirt mimics these properties, allowing you to forge through the filthy air just long enough to do your own business and move on. In fact, the very first chemical warfare defense tactic was performed using shirts as impromptu gas masks. During World War I, Canadian reserve troops held urine-soaked clothing over their face to combat chlorine gas dropped on the battlefield. So the next time you're faced with that wretched stall odor, just know that your shirt alone can actually help filter the air. And if you want to pee on your shirt for extra filtration, well, that's totally up to you.